It's always nice when companies send me stuff, right? So these guys, I believe they're in Germany. Fret Laser, a fret polishing stuff in some boxes. Let's look. Okay, so I always say this when companies send me stuff. It doesn't mean that we're engaged, okay, or to be married. I did look at their website. I don't know why the package says something different than the company. Oh, that's the company that made the box. All right. So, I'm just going to take this all out. We'll just look at everything one item at a time. And I'll tell you, I just got a old junk neck here that I have. Because I don't have a project to actually use this on. But I can see that it might be pretty cool. So that came out of one box. And we're going to go for this box, which is the one I'm kind of most interested in. Because they kind of took... Somebody's paying attention, because they kind of took something that I've sort of... Maybe, what's the word? Improvised. And they've made a better version of it. That's freaking cool. All right, let's begin. Where do we begin? At the beginning. Okay, so the idea is with this is that they've given you every grit of sandpaper known to man, right down to the micro mesh. And I'm going to say, you know what? That in itself is a cool idea, because I often quest all over to get all the different ones that I like from a different places, right down. I have stuff that goes right up to 7,000. What do they got in here? 1,500, 2,400, 4,000. Ooh, interesting. What's the next one? They're kind of stuck together, I think. They go up to 8,000. So that's cool. So the idea is, I guess I'll start with the most coarse. Oh, that's 1,500. Wow. Okay, those are really... Wow. Okay. In here is the Nadler package with other sandpapers, like I said before, that we often quest for. They give you a lot of 400. And what else? They give me some more 400. And some 3,000, 7,000. What else is in here? A big jump in sandpaper gap. But anyway, you get the idea. You've seen me use sandpapers before. Having a vast variety of different grits. 400 is always, I usually start at 320, but 400 is a good place to start. So the idea with this thing is, you use it with whatever you want. You can see, and it's got that a little contour there for a fret. For that, it's not really quite a flapper like I use. Where's my flapper? Hey, these guys, maybe we can get in business with these guys and make something a little more than this. This is my flapper, which is a little more spongy rubber for when I take sandpaper and do that technique, right? What they're offering up is that you can wrap this around and wrap it around. They give you elastics and stuff to hold this, the sandpaper on. So, and they give you one of these guys so that you could go and polish your frets. And just that little thing they made, that's cool. I don't know if I could use it as a flapper. I don't know if it is what I think it is. No, it's not. It's not wiggly enough. But that being said, flapping, sanding. See, because what I've graduated to, and you guys probably have seen me, is I'm into the fret eraser aspect of things. But like I said, not everybody has every tool. The other thing they've made is not out of metal, is a little fret rocker. But I'll just show you a trick with a fret rocker, because they reminded me of this trick. You can use a fret rocker as a spot leveler, right? So if you want to, right? So the idea being, and they've done it for you, if you find a high fret, you can use this guy, get the sandpaper cut right, wrapped around this, because it's thicker and you can hold it, and it's kind of, I don't know, it's a weird, it's not like hard plastic, but it's a different kind of plastic, so that you can hold it and do a little spot leveling, maybe get rid of a high fret. They got that. They gave me this, which is just, like I said, not everybody has everything. I have stuff, but not everybody has everything. So a little block of foam for possibly a little bit of that, you know, some of that action. That's good. And also, like I said, this is like a spot leveler for holding sandpaper in a specific area to get at a fret. That's a nice one. Then they gave me a big ass fret rocker with measuring abilities. They show it being used to measure pickup height, and I just want to make sure that if it's, no, that's pretty good stainless steel, but magnets still stick to it, right? So as a pickup height gauge, not bad. I mean, that's a rare earth magnet that sticks like hell to everything else. So this is really butch steel too. It's a really thick piece. We've got, looks like metric, imperial. They got some other measurements for string heights in millimeters for bass, acoustic, and electric. Interesting. What's on the other side? They give the same thing in, not imperial. And they got a little imperial scale with 64ths on it. Look at that. Wasn't that nice of them? All right. What I do with a lot of this stuff, and just so you know, because I do have a lot of tools of my own. Sandpaper, yeah. This. As a flapper, no. But, I don't know. I was all by myself and I had nothing. You can do one fret at a time. Oh, also, you know, they give you this guy, but you don't really need that. You just put two pieces of tape on there. That's kind of interesting. I wonder if you'd burn the crowns off it, off the frets. No, there's nothing in here coarse enough for that. Anyway, folks, I've gabbed too long. Fret laser. Depending on where you are, like I said, these guys are in Germany. So, you know, if you're on that side of the world and you need stuff, like I said, not everybody has everything. I'm going to consolidate this. I don't need two boxes. Put it all together and give it a go when I have another job. Anyway, cheers, folks. All the great links to things are below. And, I don't think you need me to put the link to fret laser, but I'll, you know, if you, I just put that into Google, FRTLZR, and you know, it popped up, and they've got a bunch of their own little tutorials there I had a peek at. But hey, looks like something that I could use. Cheers, folks. Be safe.